अस्सलाम वालेकुम स्टूडेंट्स, आवर टुडेज प्रैक्टिकल इज़ अबाउट ऑस्कल्टेशन ऑफ हार्ट साउंड्स एंड एग्जामिनेशन ऑफ पल्स. फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल वी विल डू दी ऑस्कल्टेशन ऑफ हार्ट साउंड्स. दिस डायग्राम विच आई हैव शोन यू, दिस इज़ ऑफ प्रीकॉर्डियम. वॉट इज़ प्रीकॉर्डियम? प्रीकॉर्डियम इज बेसिकली द एरिया ऑफ द चेस्ट विच इज़ ओवरलाइंग द हार्ट. ओके, इन दिस एरिया यू कैन सी, दिस इज बेसिकली द स्टर्नम. And these are the ribs and the spaces which I have labeled 2, 3, 4 and 5. These are the intercostal spaces which are present in between the ribs. Okay, for auscultation of the heart sounds, the first step is basically the localization of the intercostal spaces, because there are special areas which are located in the particular intercostal spaces where we auscultate the heart sounds. We have basically four areas on the precordium. These are the aortic area, pulmonary area, mitral area and tricuspid area. Aortic area that lies in the right second intercostal space. Now how will we count the intercostal spaces? This is the sternum. Here there is a slight elevation of the sternum, which is known as the manubrium sterni. This manubrium sterni, you can palpate it over on your own sternum even. Okay, against the manubrium sterni, second intercostal rib is located, and just below it there is second intercostal space. Then there is third rib and third space, fourth rib and fourth space, fifth rib and fifth space. Okay, you can count the ribs, the intercostal spaces this way. Similarly, these spaces are present on the right side of the chest and on the left side of the chest. Now your pulmonary area is located on the left second intercostal space. Aortic area is located in the right second intercostal space. And then tricuspid area, this is located on the left side of the lower border of the sternum. And mitral area is located in the left fifth intercostal space, just medial to the mid clavicular line. This line drawn is the mid clavicular line. This area is also known as the, is known as the apical area of the heart. And this is the area where we palpate the apex beat, which is the lowermost and outermost part of the heart where the definite cardiac pulsations, they can be felt, they can be palpated. This is your Viva question too. Now students, you auscultate the heart sounds with the help of the stethoscope. Basically there are four heart sounds which you will study in your theory. First, second, third and fourth heart sound. Why these heart sounds are produced? These are produced because of the sudden closure of the heart valves. S1 is produced because of the closure of the atrioventricular valves. S2 is produced because of the closure of the semilunar valves, which are the aortic, your aortic and pulmonary valves. S3 and S4, they are usually sometimes, S3 is not, maybe present in few young individuals normally, but it is because of the rapid inflow of the blood from the atria into the ventricles, and is indicative of the, it may be present normally, but mostly it is present in the exercise, in pregnancy, in heart failure. S4 is because of the strong atrial contraction against the diseased ventricle, like when there is stenosis of the AV valves. S4 is not present normally. The interval between the S1 and S2 is known as systole, and that present between the S2 and the next first heart sound is diastole, and this whole duration is the one cardiac cycle. First heart sound, that is not much loud. Second heart sound is very louder. Third and fourth heart sounds, they have very low pitch and they are not auscultated easily. The duration of the first heart sound is longer as compared to the first second heart sound. What you people will do on your practical notebook, you have this practical in your notebooks. You will draw this diagram of precordium and this diagram of the heart sounds. okay, you will draw it in your practical notebooks along with the today's date. Now we come to the our next part, the examination of the pulse. What is a pulse? As you already have studied, that pulse is basically a pressure wave that travels in the arteries ahead of the blood flow. Basically, the this pressure wave travels 10 times faster than the blood moves in the arteries. Pulse. You have also seen a diagram in the Guyton, which is this way, the waveform of the pulse. This is the upstroke. This is the anacrotic limb. This is the incisura, and this is the diacrotic limb, which is present in the diastole. This is the waveform of the pulse. Anacrotic limb, diacrotic limb, and this is the incisura. This diagram is present in your Guyton. Now we will here we will focus on the practical aspect of the examination of the pulse, because this practical is your short observed station, very important practical, where your command is examine the radial pulse. Most of the times we give the command examine the radial pulse. In the examination of the pulse, you have to follow a few prerequisites, as well as you see few characteristics of the pulse, which are the rate, rhythm, volume, character of the vessel wall, and comparison of the pulse. All these five qualities you check in the examination of the pulse. Now I will show you how will you examine pulse. For examination of the pulse in a subject, the subject must be sitting in a comfortable posture. The first step is that you take consent from the subject. You introduce yourself. You say, the first step is your introduction. You say that my name is Dr. XYZ. Main aapki nabz ka muayana karna chahta hoon. Main kar sakta hoon. And when the subject says yes, then you explain the procedure to him. Main aapki nabz pe haath rakhunga. Isse aapko kisi kisim ki takleef nahi hogi. Aapne pursukoon rehna hai is sari duration mein. ये कह के स्टूडेंट्स यू विल मेक द प्रॉपर पोस्चर ऑफ द आर्म ऑफ द फोर आर्म ऑफ द सब्जेक्ट. यू विल अप्रोच द सब्जेक्ट फ्रॉम द राइट साइड दिस वे, एंड द पोस्चर ऑफ द हैंड फॉर द एग्जामिनेशन ऑफ द पल्स. स्टूडेंट्स आप लोग जो हो इस एग्जामिनेशन को अपने ऊपर और अपने फैमिली मेम्बर्स के ऊपर प्रैक्टिस कर सकते हो. ठीक है, दिस इज सेमी प्रोन फ्लेक्स्ड सेमी फ्लेक्स पोजिशन. ठीक है, योर फोर आर्म इज इन द सेमी प्रोन पोजिशन एंड सेमी फ्लेक्स पोजिशन. देन वट विल यू डू, यू पल्पेट द रेडियल आर्ट्री. इफ इट इज़ अ एग्जामिनेशन ऑफ द रेडियल पल्स, योर हैंड मस्ट बी in the comfortable posture. Okay, now this is semi prone semi flex posture of the forearm. You palpate the radial artery with three fingers method. With the help of the middle finger you locate the radial artery. Now you will count the radial pulse for one whole minute. I can feel his radial pulse, and I must be having a wristwatch. I will count the pulse for the whole 1 minute. पूरे एक मिनट के लिए आपने पल्स काउंट करनी है, और मीन वाइल आपने देखना है the rate of the pulse for the whole 1 minute, the rhythm of the pulse, whether it is regular or irregular, the volume of the pulse, the character of the vessel wall, and you will compare the radial pulse with the radial pulse of the other arm. This way, in order to check for the radio-radial delay. Now, you will compare ideally your subject they should be proper exposure, because now I will check for the radiofemoral delay, and you know that femoral artery is located just beneath the inguinal ligament, and at the mid inguinal point you palpate for the femoral pulse, and for that there must be proper exposure, and you will do that radiofemoral delay, and in the end you say thank you to your subject. आपका बहुत बहुत शुक्रिया. एंड नाउ यू विल एक्सप्लेन योर फाइंडिंग्स टू योर एग्जामिनर. हाउ विल यू डिस्क्राइब योर आंसर? व्हाइल यू वर एग्जामिनिंग द रेडियल पल्स यू हैव चेक्ड द पल्स फॉर द होल 1 मिनट. दिस इज मैंडेटरी. यू विल नॉट डू इट के आप इसको 15 सेकेंड्स में देख के उसको 4 से मल्टीप्लाई कर दो. नो, पूरे 1 मिनट में आप देखोगे, और मीन वाइल आप देखोगे कि पल्स रेगुलर थी, इरेगुलर तो नहीं थी, और अगर ये इरेगुलर थी तो ये रेगुलरली इरेगुलर थी या इरेगुलरली इरेगुलर थी, बिकॉज यू नो दैट इरेगुलरली इरेगुलर पल्स यू सी इन द एट्रियल फिब्रिलेशन. Regularly irregular pulse you may see in the atrial flutter, and the volume of the pulse gives you indication about the blood volume, if the pulse, whether the pulse is of good volume or low volume. A high volume pulse may be present in the volume overload, a low volume pulse may be present in case of the volume deficit in the body. Character of the vessel wall, normally it is soft vessel, but in old age the vessel is very hard. You palpate the pulse along your in the background of your bone. In the background, you know, the bone is present and you are palpating the radial pulse, but in old age it is very hard, just like a pipe. And comparison of the pulse, you compare the pulse of the right side to the left side, and the radial pulse with the femoral pulse. Radio femoral delay is present in case of the coarctation of the aorta, or the pulse may be delayed, and there may be a delay and a difference in the count of the pulse on the right side and the left side. And how will you describe your answer to the examiner? You will say the pulse is 72 beats per minute. It is of irregular rhythm. It is of good volume. And the vessel wall was normal. There is no radial delay or radiofemoral delay. Okay, students, this was about the radial pulse. But if you get a station about the examination of the pulse, you have to examine all the pulses. You know, your carotid pulse is present along your interior border of sternocleidomastoid, just opposite the Adam's apple. You palpate your carotid pulse. Your brachial artery is present medial to your this ligament of the biceps. Radial artery, the location of the radial artery I have told you. Then in the popliteal fossa you feel for the popliteal artery and femoral artery at the mid inguinal point, and then you have the dorsal aspidus artery. Now what you guys will do, you have this practical notebook. In this practical notebook you have a table. Examination of radial pulse. This is 111 page, number 111. Yes, examination of the arterial pulse. You will study all this theory, and then there is a table. Yes, this is a table. You will fill this table. You will examine the radial artery of any of your family member. Even you can do it on your own self. Okay, you will check for the brachial artery, carotid, femoral, popliteal, posterior tibial artery and dorsal aspidus artery, and the anatomical locations of these arteries you know very well, because you have studied the upper and the lower limbs. Then you will interpret your result, all the results. You will fill this table and you will interpret your results. Okay. And you will also write down the answers. Define arterial pulse and how is it palpated, what are the components of the arterial pulse, and this I have told you, even they have been taught to you in your lecture. List the different sites where the pulse can be palpated, what are the different characters of the arterial pulse, okay, and what is the clinical significance of the arterial pulse, okay. You will fill these tables, and for examination of the precordium, you will open the examination of the CVS 147. Heart sounds. This is auscultation of the heart sounds. Okay, you will draw the diagram of the pericardium over here. Okay, diagram of the pericardium over here. This diagram, in which you wish you will show all the intercostal spaces and the respective areas where we can auscultate the heart sounds. And this diagram, you will draw this diagram.